Series of this playoff day here at ESL One Fall Bootcamp Edition, powered by Intel and also powered by some top tier Dota 2 of these two teams that did really well actually in the group stages so far. But this is their first playoff series. It's Beast Coast taking on Tundra, and I just want to get out of the way straight. Who do we favor here? Because that's they've easy. Not faced each other ever. What?
That's easy.
Is it PSG LGD?
No.
They're not
Tundra. Tundra's got something Tundra to prove. Easy? Tundra, yeah, they lost to VP only. And I think that they're like the reason. Look at Coddle Pango.
Yeah.
Who were the first people playing these heroes? Nine and Fata. Now they're top contests. Like, they have a better read on this patch, I think, already than anybody else. Beast Coast. We'll see. I think it was a weaker group. But I don't know, man. I think Tundra is like taking the tournament.
Okay.
Other than Alliance.
So I think Tundra are definitely the tournament favorites in just how they've been playing the meta. Mm-hmm. But I think Beast Coast
for this series
have a shot.
Yeah.
Yeah, they've been playing so well, and it feels like they just bring the style of Dota that really catches their opponents off guard. Tundra may have prepared for it, but on the other hand, maybe Beast Coast prepared for Tundra.
Yeah, the team at the moment has, of course, done very well in the group stages, and they are feeling strong and confident, and we hear Skeeter talk about that.
We are for sure happy because, you know, we are going to start in upper bracket for the playoffs. And I'm very happy how we understood the patch and how we, you know, theorycrafted the ideas, and they seem to all work out pretty well. It's been some time since we, like, got to taste the victory of the tournament, so like we are giving it our 100%.
Oh, I'm smelling something cooking right now. They're gonna beat out of double damage, but immediately jump back from Utora. Oh, BKB activated by Skeeter, but he only catches one of the Chronosphere, and immediately Bokushka is there with Guardian Angel. Can they keep this Leshark alive? They're having a hard time of doing it. There's just too much damage.
I think we just wanna honestly show ourselves, to show to the world that we are team capable of competing with the TI teams. Unfortunately, we didn't manage to qualify, but we still believe we can compete with these teams, and that's basically what we are trying to do in this tournament. Honestly, the way I usually look, it's just I get out of the bed, you know, I wash my face, I brush my teeth, and that's it, you know. You honestly don't want to know. You don't want to know because it's leaning towards the other way.
Yeah.
It's awesome to see. They are going up against Beast Coast, of course, who we had a little bit of a question marks with going into this tournament, because last major we saw them at the end of major, they didn't do that well, Effie. They struggled. They had high expectations on them, and they didn't deliver.
So their best performances the last year have been at DPC Season 1 and 2, where mm-hmm. they placed first and second, respectively, mm-hmm. I believe. And then at the major, they placed something like 14th or 13th.
Yeah, out in groups.
Right. And then the last tournament they played, the online one, they also placed very badly. I think maybe 7th. I'm not sure if that's the correct number. But no one really expected them to come into the group stage with their guns blazing. It really just feels like we had that interview with was it
Chris Luck?
Chris Luck, who said, we're just going to pick what we want and do what we want and just see how it works out. And for some reason, it just worked out incredibly well. Yeah. It feels like this high-paced, low cooldown meta fits them perfectly.
It really does.
Mm-hmm. So despite their poor performances in the past, I really do think we can see a lot coming out of this team.
Yeah, we have seen a little bit of the former glory of the then infamous at TI9, the run that they made there, that magic. We've seen that here a little bit already. For them, this tournament is one thing and one thing only. It's very clear. Their goal, TI10, obviously. This tournament is practice. We hear Hector talk about that one.
Sí, o sea, vinimos acá no necesariamente para ganar, o sea, vinimos a jugar para practicar. No importaba si perdíamos o si ganábamos, porque te acuerdas lo que pasó en el anterior Major, que hubo errores, no teníamos alguien que nos ayude con los picks, con los drafts, viendo que juega el enemigo y estábamos fastidiados. Yeah, solo press.
Okay, still have the skewer, the chain front. Actually skewered into the creep so they can get some bounces. And Depreskid might die because of this. Still the Sinister Gaze. It's going to be the Monivern that gets him. Schofield finishing off Alina, but Stinger will die in return. They do stun Sayu using the Spike Carpet once again. The Vendetta for extra damage. The Impale has to hit, and he does.
No conozco mucho sobre Tundra, pero sí conozco a sus jugadores, a Skitter, a Pata, a 3-3. Son muy buenos jugadores, juegan muy agresivo. Y no, a dar lo mejor a nosotros. Cuando hemos o perdamos, vamos a dar lo mejor a nosotros.
We got two aggressive teams, two fast-paced teams that like to fight, that like to brawl. I can't wait to see these two teams in action. And lucky for us, we don't really have to wait. Draft is ready after this.
Mr. Kotl, but there's a Chrono Sphere. Again, many teammates there. A beautiful disruption from Snake King, saving the Sven, at least for the time being. Skeeter trying to turn this around, getting as much lifesteal as possible. K1 gets deleted again. No buyback whatsoever as Skeeter continues to get chased, but blinks to the high ground. Looks like he's fine. Going to turn this around yet again. Stormhammer into the right clicks. And yeah, this is looking very, very bad for Beast Coast as Skeeter is very happy with that turn of events. Buyback now. Wow. Onto 9 and turns into a 5v0. And it looks like they're just going to go for Throne.
Tundra just was really good. Like,
and GG is called.
Yep.
So Tundra take the 2-0. They will face Virtus Pro in the next round. While Beast Coast goes to the lower bracket. I'm not even sure who they're playing, actually. Maybe it's not decided yet. Either way, they're still in the
Yeah, tournament. I think they're waiting for their opponents, so they won't know just yet. But yeah, we get the rematch from the top of Group A. It'll be Tundra against VP again. Last time around, VP won 2-0 fairly convincingly. Tundra looking hot in this series, as they did in many of their other group series. So I still think VP is going to be a very challenging opponent either way, even though Tundra looked amazing today as usual. That's going to be a hell of a series coming up. I believe that is tomorrow, if
sure.
I'm not mistaken.
Sure.
That should be tomorrow.
Yeah, but I'm sure that's right.
Yep. I'm getting
Sheever's
a thumbs up
from
Sheever. It's either because I'm right or because she thinks I look good today. She's like, wow, that shirt looks so good on you. That's what it is.
No, I don't think that's it.
That's not it. It could have been that.
So first game, 9 absolutely destroyed, went 17-0. This time he died a bunch on Batray, but you know the presence that he had still had a huge impact. And we can look at the score. Who was it? It was Skeeter on the Sven, 23-2. That's the best Sven game I think we've seen the entire tournament. He completely dominated.
And I think it's a mark of a really good team when you can have 9 have incredible performances, incredible games, and then there's a game here where he's getting countered and shut down more. Somebody else steps up to the plate and gets the job done, right? So all of them, in their own way, can carry these games and have huge impact. So, yeah, wonderfully done. Tundra just clearly better today. There's no other way of looking at it. They just beat Beast Coast and Square in both games.
Indeed. Let's see what the panel has to say about that.
Well, I would say the long and short of it all would be Tundra just played better. But we're going to expand on that and talk to one of the winners after this.